Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can create an array of objects in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You too can become a hero and save our channel by punching the like button, throw a comment down below, and smash the subscribe button. Alright guys and gals, in this video I'm going to be explaining how we can create an array of objects. Now here's a few examples of arrays that we've worked on in the past. So the standard formula or steps to creating an array is to type in the data type that we're working with, a name for this array equals new, the data type again, and then a size if you don't plan on assigning values right away from the beginning when you declare this. So we have an array of integers, an array of characters, and an array of strings. So what if we wanted to create an array of objects? For example, I have a class called food. We're going to be storing some food objects within an array. So following these simple steps, let's begin creating an array of objects. So we begin by typing in the name of the data type that we are working with. The name of the data type that we are working with is food for this example. So we're going to type in food, followed by a set of straight braces. And then we need a name for this array. So we could call this foods, but I don't think that would make too much sense. So let's pretend that we're placing food in a refrigerator. Equals new, the data type again, which is food. And then a size if we do not plan on assigning values right away. So let's say that this refrigerator can hold 3 food items. So we now have an array that can hold some food objects for us. Now let's create some food objects. So let's do this after we create our array called refrigerator. So let's create 3 foods to store within this refrigerator. So we type in the name of the class, which is food. Let's call this food1 equals new food. And let's set up the constructor of our food class. So it's the same name as the class. And let's say we want to set up a parameter for a name, string name. This dot name equals name. And then we need to declare this outside of the constructor, string name. So when we create a food, we need to pass in a name. So for food1, let's say that this is pizza. And we'll create a food2 item and a food3 item. Let's say food2 will be a hamburger, we'll pass that in as an argument, and food3 will be a hot dog. So we now have 3 food items. Now we are going to store these food items in our array of food objects, our refrigerator as we call it. So in order to do that, we type in the name of the array, followed by an index. So this always begins at 0 because computers always start with 0. So our refrigerator at index 0, let's store food item number 1, which is our pizza. And for index 1, we'll store food 2. And index 2, we'll store food 3. And for practice, let's attempt to access one of these elements of our array of food objects called refrigerator and display it to the console window. So we can do that with a println statement. And let's attempt to access whatever food object is at index 0. So refrigerator, index 0, and let's see what happens. Now remember that this returns the array of where this object is in your computer's memory. So this is the address of where food1 is located in memory. What I'm trying to do is access the name variable of our food object. So I'm going to tack on dot name to the end of this because we have a name variable for all of our food objects. So this will print the name of whatever food is in element number 0 of our refrigerator, which is pizza. And we can do the same process for the other elements too. So I'm going to print element number 1 as well as element number 2. So if we were to take a look at all of the elements within our refrigerator, we have pizza, a hamburger, and a hot dog. Now there's another way of writing this too. Instead of declaring our array of food objects called refrigerator and setting a memory size, this time we're going to declare our array of food objects and assign all of these values right away. So after we create our food objects, let's declare and assign these values to our array of food objects. So we type in the name of the data type, followed by a name, refrigerator, equals, and then within curly braces, all of the values that we would like to add. We would like to add food 1, food 2, and food 3. And we do not need these lines anymore, so we can take these out. And this will do the exact same thing, but we changed the order of the steps around. So that's the basics of arrays of objects in Java. If you'd like a copy of all of this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of arrays of objects in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.